Well, what have we here? Tarzan. Yeah, I remember Tarzan. Pretty decent film from Disney, before they made the lucrative decision to trash their own reputation and legacy along with various others, alienating most of their fans in the process. Ah, simpler times. And since my last video was the biggest, hardest, and most frustrating I've worked on, I've been looking for something simple for my next project. Something light, as a nice little palate cleanser to take away the bitter taste of the Phantom Menace. And yeah, this should work. Looks simple enough, I mean, it shouldn't be too much trouble. Right. And yeah, that's the intro. What, were you expecting me to talk about the film or something? Nope, haven't seen it in years. I mean, it's fine enough from what I remember, decent soundtrack. Oh, and it's got the God Among Men himself, Brian Blessed, in it.
I made it, thanks to my trusty fruit knife.
So yeah, that's cool, and yeah, that's it. Subscribe! So Tarzan was developed by Eurocom Entertainment Software.
Electronic fun for everyone.
Yeah, I'll be the judge of that, thank you very much. And published by Sony Computer Entertainment and Disney Interactive in 1999. It was on PS1, N64, Windows and Game Boy Color. Although once again, I've only played it on PS1, so as always, that's what we're focusing on. So we hit start and find our titular hero as a precocious young whippersnapper, running wild through the jungle and annoying the hell out of the other residents. Why they haven't made a lovely child-sized snack out of him yet, I have no idea. And notice that the cutscenes are the actual clips from the actual film. Yeah, they didn't try and draw their own just to make more work for themselves when they could have just used the footage from the film, which looks a million times better anyway, like the makers of a certain other game that we recently looked at did. Yeah. So we get started and say, oh, it's a side-scroller. I don't think we've tried one of them before. Well, this should be easy. I mean, side-scrollers aren't hard. Right. But anyway, what can this plucky little crotch monkey do? Well, you can run around and jump, the height determined by how long you hold the button down for. You can climb on stuff and swing on vines, because of course. I mean, a Tarzan game where you can't swing on vines is like a Star Wars game where the lamest weapon is your fucking lightsaber. Yeah, I know. Ridiculous, right? Oh, and if you hold down the circle button, you can go full monkey man and start pounding the ground with your fists. And if you do it over certain areas, you can break through, which usually reveals collectibles. And what about defense? Because yeah, welcome to the jungle! Everything's trying to kill you! And I mean everything, which I guess is kind of like how it is in real life. So in a way, this is probably the most realistic game we've looked at so far. But anyway, I guess the developers decided to take a page out of a Bug's Life's book since your main weapon is the fruit that you just kind of pull out of your arse to throw at your enemies, which makes them explode and turn into a swarm of butterflies. Man, where's poor old Sparks when you need him? He's really missing out. If he was here, you can bet he'd be chowing down like old Brucey on some tasty Robert Shaw right about now. You've got two methods of throwing. You can do a quick underhand throw or overhand, which is slower but lets you hit enemies that are further away. The default fruit is pretty weak, to the point where even the wimpiest enemies require multiple hits to take them out, but you can get other fruit that do more damage. There's a few different types, which all pretty much do the same thing from what I can tell. Seriously, I'm really not all that sure what the difference between them is. They all just explode to do more damage. I guess maybe some can travel further or have a wider area of effect, but that's about it. So yeah, if you ever find yourself in the jungle, not only do you have the wildlife to worry about, but there's also fruit stuffed with gunpowder just left lying around. You take one bite and it blows your head clean off your shoulders. Man, the jungle's a scary place, alright. Fucking Bear Grylls never mentioned any of this shit. Oh, and if blowing up cute little animals with explosive fruit just doesn't do it for you, if you want to get up close and personal so you can savour all the little emotions, you can get a little knife, although it looks more like a spearhead to me, but whatever, that you can use to stab and slash the poor creatures. Because remember kids, knives are your friends! However, I found myself rarely using it, due to reasons we'll get into in a bit. So yeah, that's the name of the game. You're just going through the jungle, destroying all the fauna that's unfortunate enough to get in your way. Which, kinda reminds me of what we're doing in these sorts of environments in real life right now. Yeah, when you think about it, this whole game's really just an allegory for the effect our species has had and still is having on this world that we call home, and how, at the heart of it, we're just a nasty little virus that's slowly destroyed its host to the point that'll eventually not be able to support any life, and we'll only have ourselves to blame, and in all honesty, that's really all we deserve. Man, who said video games couldn't be deep? Oh, and if you're one of these soft-hearted, compassionate snowflakes and you just can't bear to hurt the poor little critters, then you can actually just jump over or run past most of them. But anyway, as you're going through the first few levels, if you're like me, you'll probably be saying, you know what, this is actually pretty good. It controls well, it looks nice, and overall, it's just really fun. Unlike a certain other game I recently took a look at. There's a few collectibles for you to find. You've got these, I don't know, Tarzan coins or whatever, scattered throughout each level, and every time you collect 100, you get an extra life. Then you've got the letters, again, like a Bug's Life, and if you collect all of them, you unlock some extra clips from the film. And then you've got these sketch fragments, and if you find all of them, you unlock some small bonus levels. So that's pretty cool. But let me tell you, you're gonna have a real game on your hands to find all this stuff, since some of it's surprisingly well hidden. You've seriously gotta leave no stone unturned if you want to find everything. And oh, look what we have here! Checkpoints! Yeah, wow. Now there's a real innovation right there. What year did this come out again? Oh yeah, 1999. What else came out that year? Hey Phantom Menace, you got your pen and paper handy? You better be writing this shit down! But even though the game, for the most part, is a side-scroller, there are a few bits where it goes full 3D, like in the bonus levels, and the level where you're being chased by the elephants and you've got to stay ahead of them or you'll get smushed, pretty much like the boulder levels in Crash Bandicoot. In fact, that's where this game gets a lot of its cues from. But this isn't the only point where you go 3D. See, this isn't a 2D side-scroller, but a 2.5D side-scroller, a term which I'm ashamed to admit I'd never actually heard of before looking up this game. So while the majority of the game is viewed from the side on, there's plenty times where it seamlessly transitions to a 3D perspective. It's done well and helps to make the gameplay a bit more interesting and less repetitive than what you might expect from just a 2D side-scroller. And since I just mentioned them, let's take a look at these bonus levels. They're nothing complex, just some short time segments that give you the chance to collect some extra coins so you can get a few more lives, which, believe me, you're gonna need as you get further along. They're fine enough, although it is a bit annoying that you only get one chance to do them, so if you don't do very well and want to try again, you've got to go back through the main level and collect all the sketch pieces again. So after a few levels, like in the film, we jump forward a number of years to find our hero as a grown man. His balls have dropped, there's hair in places there wasn't before, and he's got some strange wet spots in his loincloth in the morning. But aside from that, he plays pretty much the same as before. So yeah, this game seems pretty simple, right? A nice little Disney game that should keep the kids happy for a while? What's not to like? But as we all know, looks can be deceiving, and things are rarely what they seem. And this is the case here, since while the game is simple, it does become surprisingly difficult after just a few levels. See, since you're playing as such an athletic and agile character as Tarzan, your first instinct will probably be to go tear-arsing through the jungle as fast as possible, like the Monkey Man himself. Which yeah, you can if you want, but it won't be long before you start losing lives and seeing that game over screen. Yeah, in truth, in order to get through safely, you've got to take things slow and steady, careful to time your jumps properly and avoid enemies. I mean, there's just so much stuff that can hurt you that you can barely move 2 inches without getting hit by something. One thing you really need to be careful with is jumping. See, when you're gallivanting through the jungle and come to a jump, you've got to make sure to press the jump button at the exact right moment. If you press the button when you're right on a ledge, you won't jump and just fall in and die. Instead, you've got to press the button slightly before you hit the edge in order to make it. So yeah, that's just something you need to watch out for, and one of the reasons why you need to take things slow and steady. Then there's the vine swinging. While it's implemented well, again, you do have to be careful with it. See, when you're swinging on a vine and want to jump off, either to get to the next one or reach the next bit of land, you have to wait until you're at pretty much the apex of the swing before you do, because otherwise you'll just let go and again fall to your death. Oh, and it also has one of my biggest pet peeves when it comes to these sorts of games. The enemies only have to touch you to do damage. And you better believe me when I say everything's your enemy in this fucking jungle. Birds, monkeys, cat things, even the frogs. I mean, yeah, I know frogs can be some of the most poisonous things in the world, but I doubt just nudging one with your foot's gonna do much harm. I mean, as long as you don't put the thing in your mouth, you should be okay, right? But anyway, yeah, the enemies only have to touch you to hurt you, because apparently in the jungle, every creature secretes fucking VX nerve agent through their skin or something. So you'll just be running along, minding your own business, and if one of your toes so much as comes into contact with something breathing, and sometimes stuff that isn't breathing, and it's pretty much like you just got a load of sarin gas sprayed in your face. Oh, and remember earlier when I said the knife isn't a very good weapon? Yeah, this is the reason why. Since in order to knife things, you've got to get up close to them because, yeah, that's how knives work. See, don't say you don't learn anything on this channel. But yeah, it's hard to get near the critters to stick them without getting touched yourself, so you're just gonna end up losing health. And to be honest, it's easier just to throw fruit at them or to just jump over. So really, there's no point to the knife whatsoever. I mean, you don't use it for anything else from what I can tell. But that's nothing compared to another one of my pet peeves, and by that I mean total fucking bullshit that makes me want to put my fucking fist through the screen. And you may have noticed that I've been trying to cut down on my swearing for this video, but you don't get to pull some annoying shit like this and not expect to get a few F-bombs dropped on your sorry arse. But yeah, it's got the same fucked up bullshit game over thing that for some strange reason all these Disney games had a raging hard on for back in the day. See, in most games from this period, you run out of lives, you go back to the start of the level with a couple fresh lives and you try again. But for some reason, and it seems, at least from my fucking experience, that it was just the Disney games that did this shit, here, when you lose all your lives, instead of just going back to the start of the level, it kicks you back to the opening menu and you've got to load the game again. And if you had like one life left when you last saved, that's all you've got to start with when you load the game. Mean that once you get one game over, it's easy to get another one straight after, and then another one! So yeah, it's the same irritating bullshit we saw in things like Toy Story 2 and A Bug's Life, etc. And yeah, it might not sound like such a big issue, but as the game gets harder, and believe me, this game does get harder, unless you're some kind of fucking Apex Legends wunderkind with the reflexes of a fucking cat, you're probably gonna be getting game over more and more often, and it's just gonna get more and more fucking annoying every time you fucking do! Oh, and every time you've got to listen to fucking Tarzan roast you for your failure. He's like,
"Your game is over. Next time be more careful."
Like, yeah, no shit, dickhead. And why does he sound like fucking John Kramer telling you the rules to his latest game?
"Hello, Tarzan. I want to play a game. I suggest you be careful. Otherwise, it may cost you and your friends dearly."
Oh, and also, when it brings you back to the main menu, of course, the fucking start new game option's highlighted. So if you're getting a bit flustered and just want to get back into the game as quick as possible, it's not hard to hit new game by accident, and then you've got no choice but to sit and wait for the game to load so then you can quit again and load your progress. And yeah, it doesn't take that long, but it's still irritating, especially when you're already fucking irritated. So about halfway through, you'll come to the bit where you've got to fight the leopard Sabor. Yeah, it's a boss fight. And this is where things get really annoying. So we've got to fight this bitch now, and all of a sudden you've got a spear just out of nowhere. Where we hiding that, Tarzan, eh? So the spear works pretty much like an extended version of the knife, cause that's kinda what a spear is when you think about it, But anyway, you've got to run it through before you become leopard food. But you've got to time your attacks right in order to do damage. See, when you're getting close, you've got to hit her before she attacks, because if you hit her after she begins her attack, you can't interrupt her, so you just end up getting hit instead. And you don't even do any damage either, because apparently while you're in the process of attacking somebody, you just become temporarily invincible for no reason. But that's not all, because after you hit her, you better be ready to jump, because she then comes charging at you full throttle, and she moves fast, so you've got to be quick on the button to avoid her. And even though you need to be close to her to hurt her, you've got to be careful not to get too close, because if you do, then it's really hard to avoid her and she just starts beating the shit out of you, and she can take off a good chunk of health before you manage to get away. Anyway, after you take down her health, she runs off and then it's back to the platforming, but now you've got to be extra careful, because this isn't the last time she'll crawl out from under a stone, and every hit you take just leaves you weaker for when she turns up next. So yeah, you'll face her two more times throughout the level, and both times Tarzan will just miraculously have his spear again. So I guess he really does keep it up his arse in between fights. Man, that can't be comfortable when you run through the jungle. But in any case, her behaviour doesn't change, although she does get this arsehole bird sidekick who'll be flying around above, so now you've got to time your jumps right to avoid both her and this flying rat fuck. Yeah, you can bet I was saving my game like my life depended on it after finally beating this shit.
Good idea. Always best to save now and again.
Oh god, it's talking to me. Man, that's weird. And I know this is a thing in most PS1 games, but I just thought of it here, and I've always found it pretty funny. When you go to load the game, you've got to choose the block that it occupies on the memory card. But when you do, it shows you all the other games saved on the card, as if it needs to be told which game you want to load. Which I guess is true, but it's like it's saying, oh, which game would you like to load? And you're just like, you know what, I feel like loading Star Wars, even though that's not the game I'm playing. Yeah. Anyway, it's onto the next level, where instead of playing as our hero, the title character, we're playing as that silly old Billy Jane getting chased by the baboons. The jungle doesn't seem so lovely right now, does it? And this bit was annoying as well, because you're moving pretty fast and there's just so much shit in your way that you can barely make it through without getting knocked around all over the place like a fucking swing ball. But then you'll make it far enough and then our hero, our true hero, does what all males do when they see a female getting dogpiled in a multiplayer match and swoops into the rescue, whether she likes it or not. And then you've got this bit where you're, I don't know, surfing on the tree branches and you've got to avoid even more shit in your way. These bits appear a couple times throughout the game and you really do need the reflexes of a leopard to get through them unscathed, and even then that might not be enough. See, there's branches and shit that you've either got to duck under or jump over, but again, you're moving so fast and it's not always clear which way you need to duck to get under some of them, so it's hard to make it through without getting hit, which is especially annoying if you've already got low health from the previous battering you just took, which doesn't even make sense considering you were playing as Jim before and now you're playing as fucking Tarzan. Like, what, are they the same fucking person or something? Why don't they have separate health bars? So yeah, these bits could be annoying, but I appreciate their inclusion, since even though the game is decent, it doesn't really do much that we haven't seen in similar games from the time, like again, Crash Bandicoot. But these bits seem pretty original. I mean, not in terms of concept, it's just a standard Unreal segment, but the way it's presented and executed does feel a bit unique and shows that the game did have some thought put into it. I mean, after all, it is just another Disney movie tie-in, so you could have almost expected them to put the barest amount of effort in, but thankfully, that's not the case here. Time for the next level, and while our hero is off courting with his new bit of coos, we're playing as his little gorilla friend, Turk or some shit, as she and her ilk mess around and trash the explorer's camp. So I must say that I was actually quite impressed with the graphics. They're nice and colourful, they do a good job of emulating the look of the film, and the character models are well detailed. At least they look better than whatever the fuck this shit's meant to be.
What the fuck is that?
Oh, and when did these two games come out? Oh yeah, the same fucking year. I mean, just how? Just looking at them, would you really believe that this was released the same year as this? I'm not sure I would. The voice acting's pretty good too. There's not a whole lot outside of the film clips, but the bits in the menus and during gameplay are decent enough, and they even have some of the main actors from the film. For instance, Tony Goldwyn voices Tarzan, just as he does in the film, and they've also got the Phenom himself, no not that one, Brian Blessed playing the villain again. Yeah, they actually managed to get him, unlike a certain other game, yeah you know I'm talking about you. The soundtrack's decent as well. It's kind of standard for this type of game, it's bright and upbeat and fits well with the whole jungle aesthetic. It's not the most memorable I've ever heard, but it does the job, which is usually the case with these Disney games. Anyway, the next couple levels are pretty much just more of the same, but then we get to the level where you've got to rescue the gorillas from the hunters, and this is where the game goes from being a bit difficult to an absolute scumbag piece of shit. How you ask? Well, let's just take a look. So the game goes 3D again, but we're going forward this time, which just makes the whole thing with having to jump at the exact right moment just that little more difficult, because it's harder to judge how close you are to edges from this perspective. But that's not all, because then you come to this bit where you're riding on the back of the elephant. Okay, fine. But then you've got these parts where you've got to duck under these branches, and fuck me, these fucking bits made me want to throw my fucking controller out the fucking window. So you've got to duck under these branches, but just like with the jumping, you've got to make sure to do it at the exact right moment, which again is easier said than done, because like I just said, it's harder to judge distances from this perspective. But Davey, I hear you say, why don't you just duck earlier and stay down until you've cleared the branch? Well, that does sound like the smart thing to do, but no, because unlike in the branch surfing bits where you've pretty much got to do the same thing, here, instead of staying down for as long as you keep the button pressed, Tarzan gets back up after like half a second. So you'll duck in time, but then the daft fucker will stick his empty fucking head back up before you've cleared the branch, so he gets clocked on the dome and great, now you're dead. So basically, you've got to time this shit just right to make it under. And I mean right down to the fucking millisecond. For fuck's sake. But it's not over, because once you make it through that shit, you've then got to get past these fuckholes throwing rocks and barrels and shit at you. Okay, whatever, I guess I'll just run past them. No, not that simple. You'll make it past this first guy, okay, but then you'll come to this asshole who stands in your way so you can't get past. Even if you manage to get around him, you can't go any further. Like what, has he got a fucking invisible force field or something? What the fuck? So then you'll try to kill him, but you can pelt this motherfucker with fruit and stab him until he's got more holes than a block of Swiss cheese and it won't make a difference. So what the fuck are you supposed to do? Well, you've actually got to take out the fuckhead throwing the barrels first, and then you can get rid of the other guy. Yeah, it's a no survivor situation. You've got to wipe out every motherfucker in your path, and you can't go any further until you do. It's like Tarzan's got a voice in his head going,
"Wipe them out. All of them."
So anyway, once you finally make it past all that shit, it's time for the final battle with Clayton.
Clayton. Nerd.
And if you thought it couldn't get any worse, ho, just you, fucking wait. So we've got to fight this arsehole, but before we can do that, first we've got to get to the top of apparently the tallest and widest tree in the whole fucking world. But you can't stop, because you've got this son of a bitch chasing you, and if he catches you, he eats you off the tree and you die. So you've just got to keep running as fast as you can, but then you've got enemies coming at you from the front, and I've got no fucking clue how you're meant to get past without getting hit. You can jump over, but unless you hit the button at apparently the exact right nanosecond, they'll still hit you. I mean, you can't kill them, because then you've got to stop, and then this wanklord catches you. And again, every time you get hit, just leaves you weaker for the final fight. So you make it to the top, and then finally you can beat the shit out of the fucker. Hey, you leave Brian Blessed alone! He's a national treasure! But anyway, this is the most annoying bit of all, even though it is pretty simple. You've just got to avoid his attacks and then hit him a few times to make him fall to his death. The problem is, you can only hurt him at certain moments, and the windows for when you can avoid his attacks are tighter than Melania's asshole. He'll shoot you with his rifle, and you've got to make like Neo and dodge that shit. Then he'll throw knives at you, and you've got to be careful not only to jump at the right time, but also in the right way to avoid them. Remember the thing about holding down the button to jump higher? Yeah, if you're like me, your first instinct might be to jump as high as you can, but if you do that, you'll still get hit when he throws out multiple knives at different speeds. So you've got to jump high, but not too high, and fast, but not too fast, and then you can only hit him when he's doing his posturing thing or whatever. And he does quite a bit of damage with each hit, on top of the fact that you've probably lost some of your health from running up the tree. Yeah, I hated this bit. This bit was the absolute fucking worst, and I had no lives left, meaning that every time I got killed, I got game over and had to reload. It got to the point where I went back through some of the earlier levels just so I could get some extra lives, and then I just lost them all again. And every time you get game over at this point, you get Brian Blessed roasting you.
Come on, shape up!
Well, to be honest, that's actually kind of worth it. So anyway, with enough time and patience, you finally beat Clayton and they all live happily ever after until, I don't know, fucking Tarzan 2 or whatever.
Look at that, you finished the whole thing! Way to go! Now you definitely have to try the hard difficulty level.
Are you fucking kidding, mate? The fucking hard difficulty? It was hard enough on fucking normal! Am I shite doing this shit again on fucking hard? You can fuck off! So that was Tarzan on PS1, and in conclusion, yeah, it's pretty good. Better than I was expecting, to be honest. It's a nice little platformer with a surprising amount of thought and effort put into it. It's not particularly original and takes most of its cues from other platformers of the time, but it's fun enough to look past that. The graphics are decent, as are the voice acting and music, and it has enough ideas that it doesn't become repetitive. It does get a bit hard and frustrating at times, and has some annoying aspects, like the stupid game over shit, but it doesn't drag the game down all that much. And it's got the legend Brian Blessed, so that automatically makes it a classic in my books. So if retro platformers are your thing, then you should consider checking this one out. And yeah, that's about it. Well, there's another one done. Hope you liked it. I think I'll go and have a wank. But first, thank you very much for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, then leave a like. If you didn't, then tell me to go fuck myself. We're trying to hit 1,000 subscribers by the end of the year, so if you like my content and have yet to subscribe, I would be extremely grateful if you would do so. And as always, thank you so much to everyone who already has. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.